So let us look at how derangement of the neuroendometabolic stress response can progress, how it kind of spreads, and how to identify some of what these symptoms really mean, okay?
So let's discuss a typical presentation of NEM malfunction and clients that we talk to every day. So Jane is a 52-year-old female. She presents with fatigue, and that's her main complaint. For the past few years, she's been needing a cup of coffee every morning, and in that cup of coffee, she puts 2 tablespoons of sugar. Though she loves sweets, she gets hungry really quickly after even eating a high-carbohydrate meal. She's also started to notice that she's gained some weight around the belly. She's now starting to crave some salty foods, and sometimes certain foods don't agree with her GI system. Sometimes when she bends down to pick up something, she gets lightheaded and has to hold herself steady.
Does this sound like you? Or does it sound like normal to you? On the surface, it doesn't sound much. But this, if you really understand the physiologist that we described earlier and tied it together, this can actually represent the early part of the neuroendometabolic stress response in the early steps, which is the activation. So signs of increased metabolic demand are plentiful. If you look at what was described by Dr. Jeremy, the sugar craving, okay? That means the body is requiring you to have more energy. Why? Because energy is required to overcome stress as far as the body is concerned. Number two, you have central weight gain, especially the muffin tops. Because why? Because the adrenals are focused on retaining the weight in order to slow down and conserve energy, and most of it goes to the central portion. These are metabolically driven events. They are not a very, very intense at first. They are subtle. So you don't write them off because there's already a body is telling you that something is wrong inside. They often go unnoticed. The neuroendocrine circuit, by the way, now we have been talking so far, the metabolic circuit is being activated. Now don't forget the body is very, very, very smart. While the metabolic circuit, the bioenergetic circuit is being activated, the body also activates the neuroendocrine component, but in a much lesser degree. Now, symptoms can include a little blood pressure, instability, and mild electrolyte imbalances, a craving of salt, things like that. But they're relatively mild. It's mostly predominant the metabolic early subtle signs, okay? So Dr. Carey, let's go on.
So as Jane continued at her job, she found that she was getting a little more stressed at work. She's been having more nervousness, and sometimes before she goes to bed at night, she just feels her heart pounding really loudly at night. And despite being very tired, you know, she can't fall asleep and sometimes wakes up multiple times at night. So she decides to take some sleepy time teas or some melatonin to help her get to bed. And then she now goes through menopause, which was actually very rough on her, as she had hot flashes, some dry skin, some vaginal dryness and itching. And she tries to get exercise because everyone knows it's good for you, but it really tires her out even easier. So she goes to see her doctors, who tries to run labs, and everything actually comes back normal.
So it's not only about Jane. Male also has the same problem, libido going down, reduced exercise capacity, feeling drained at the end of the day, some inability to sleep, feeling a little bit down from time to time. These also are subtle signs. What is it really saying here? In terms of the neuroendometabolic stress response, you are now stepping into the second phase, or what is called overdrive. Now, as the stress continues unabated, the neuroendocrine component, we remember the six, one side of the diagram, which is the three systems and three circuits and the six system component, they become more activated. They become more in demand. They are really going on full speed now, the neuroendocrine component. So the cardiomyopathic circuit is hard working. They lead to nervousness, for example. Sometimes the heart have an experience of occasional palpitation. Sometimes you have little skip beats here and there. The neuroaffect circuit become more involved, leading to trouble sleeping because the body become more wired. And even though you're tired, you can fall asleep after a little while, but then you tend to wake up, for example. And then the hormonal circuit becoming more a problem. So in the female, it would be the old axis imbalances, as well as menopause, as well as fatigue, and the male will be reduced in libido and exercise intolerance. So together, again, you can see there's a neuroendocrine component, there is a metabolic component. In the overdrive step, which is the phase two, then both are ongoing. However, the important thing to note in this overdrive phase is the prominence of the neuroendocrine component becomes more and more and more servicing. So while the metabolic component still on the low end of things is kind of like sleepy, but it's just starting to wake up, okay? So most of the symptoms that people complain of the this overdrive phase consists of neuroendocrine symptoms, okay? So let's continue and see how Jane goes on.
So now she has gone to multiple doctors and practitioners who have tried to put her on some medications, some herbs, some glandulous, and some vitamins. She feels better for just a little bit, and then her symptoms start to worsen again. She has had multiple fatigue crashes, especially after big work events or family events. She has constant heart pounding. Sleep is not improved, even with over-the-counter sleep aids. Her brain fog starts to settle in more, and she has a really hard time concentrating. She becomes even more sensitive to supplements, sometimes actually having the opposite reaction, such as she was taking vitamin C, and instead of it making her feel better, it actually crashed her and she was on the couch for a week. She's now unable to smell certain perfumes, and she gets headaches from just even walking by someone who has really strong perfume, or even just filling up gas in a gas station, she also gets headaches. And she's also tried limiting her diet to gluten-free and dairy-free, and yet still her GI symptoms are not improving.
And so this is not only limited to Jane. In fact, I went through much of what you described with Jane, and this is no joke. This is not funny because it is very debilitating. I was in bed for weeks and couch bound. But look at what is really going on physiologically is that if you look at the neuroendometabolic stress response, you are now entering the exhaustion phase. So if stress is not well controlled and it continues to attack you, then the entire neuroendometabolic response enters what we call the exhaustive phase. This is after the activation and the overdrive. In this exhaustion phase, which is perhaps the most alarming, because it is the point that the velocity of the declining health enters its maximum speed. Frequent crashes is very common. You will not be able oftentimes to go to work. You can be couch bound. Just getting up and walking around the block can be problematic. And so this is very, very problematic. And this is where most people finally decided to visit their healthcare professional, which is a good thing. However, this is also the beginning of one of the most dangerous part of the journey because of well-intentioned heroic effort that turned bad. Not because the health professional is not well-intentioned, but because they don't understand there is two components. So the tendency is to just focus on the neuroendocrine by propping up what we call the adrenal side without attention to the metabolic side. So crashes can become more debilitating. As both the neuroendocrine and the metabolic component problem surfaces, and they will rise to the top, and now the symptoms become so convoluted that most practitioners just give up, you see what I'm saying, okay?
And I remember you had a lot of these symptoms when you were going through this, right?
And that's the biggest challenge, is how to sort it out. We are logical creatures. We tend to try to figure out what is wrong. But when so many things is coming at you, you know, inability to sleep, feeling wired, nauseated, and feeling lightheaded, you know, all these, and your doctor tells you everything is fine. So you're just simply confused. And that's what happened to me, you see what I'm saying, too. Mm-hmm.
So from the neuroendocrine perspective, the body enters a state of hormonal dysregulation beyond the HPA axis. If it is a female like Jane, the OAT axis can become disturbed. They might have irregular periods, irritability, cramping, hot flashes, cyclical symptoms may worsen. Their thyroid issues might also not improve and might actually worsen despite medications. and their fatigue now goes throughout the day. And then you have the neuroendocrine derangements that also become more severe in the cardiomyopathy and the neuroaffective symptoms, like daily adrenal crashes, your heart gets pounding consistently throughout the day. They bend down, they pick up something, they get lightheaded, they have nervousness or mood issues, and the inability to sleep despite using sleep aids.
And perhaps the most devastating part is the emotional. Because with this convolution of symptoms, I was lucky because my wife, who is a registered dietitian, and helped me to kind of decipher all this because she knows the biochemical reactions that goes on. But most people are not so fortunate, and most healthcare providers are not in tune. And most of the family members, despite their well intentions, have no idea. And then they think it's all in your mind, but actually it's not.
That's right. And that can be really, really tough on a person and actually increase more stress and worsen your condition as well.
Yeah, so it actually becomes a vicious cycle because when you have more stress that's unresolved, your mental state becomes confused. You can become discouraged, you become frustrated, you see, and you become almost down, so to say, you see. And then the body then continue to get worse because, you know, when you have these negative emotions, it actually compounds the problem and drives the NEM response into the last stage, which is?
That's right. It's still in exhaustion. And from a metabolic perspective, the body can experience these kinds of symptoms, such as increasing food sensitivities. You find yourself getting sick more often and you have a lowered immune system. You have multiple chemical sensitivities. You have paradoxical reactions to supplements and medications that should be helping you, but they're making you worse. You're really unable to handle detoxes, and your body just enters a catabolic state.
Now, remember, even in this exhaustive phase, it's a continuum. You know, some people in the early part of the exhaustion, some people in the middle, some people is in the tail end. And the symptoms can range so much because not everybody have all the symptoms. It really depends on how weak and which component and which system is this imbalance, and that's usually the first one to come up.